Yeah, hi everyone. Now let us discuss this problem 11. A retailer buys a TV from a wholesaler for rupees 40,000. He marks the price of TV 15% above his cost price and sell it to the consumer at 5% discount on the marked price. If the sales are intra-state and the rate of GST is 12%, find the marked price of the TV. Okay, so first question, first the retailer buys TV from wholesaler for rupees, so cost price, if you see the cost price is rupees 40,000, marked price, so marked price is, he marks the price of TV 15% above his cost price, so 15% above, that means it is 1 plus 15 divided by 100 times this 40,000. Okay, so this will give you, I can cancel with 5 5 3 is 15 and 5 2 is 10, so it is 1 plus 3 divided by 20 into 40,000. So this will give you 23 divided by 20 multiplied by 40,000. Okay, so this come out to be 23 multiplied by this will be 2000. Okay, so this is 46,000. So 46,000 is marked price. Okay, so 15% more, 46,000 is the marked price. The amount which the consumer pay for the TV. Okay, now there is a discount of 5%. So as there is a discount of 5% on marked price, so therefore selling price it will be 1 minus 5 divided by 100 times this 46,000. So this 5 and the 5, 5 to the 1 upon 20, so it is 20 minus 1, it is 19. So it is 19 upon 20. So it is 19 upon 20 into 46,000. This is equals to this 00 we cancel, and this is 19 into, we cancel with 2, so it is 2 2 the 4 2 3 the 6, so 19 into 2300. So 19 here, it is 0 0, 19 3 the 57, so 5 we have, 19 to the 38, 38 plus 5, it is 43. So 43,700 is the selling price, but the customer will pay GST also. So here we will find central government GST, CGST, paid by customer. So the rate of GST is 12%, so CGST we will count at 6%, so 6 upon 100 multiplied by the selling price is 43,700, so these two zero will cancel. Now 6 7 is 42, 4 we have, 6 3 is 18, 18 plus 4 it is 22. Now 2, 6, 4 is 24 plus 2, 26. So 2622, this is the CGST paid by the customer. Similarly, SGST, so therefore SGST, okay. SGST paid by customer. Now, this CGST or SGST, the consumer will pay to the dealer or whatever shop owner, retailer. Okay. So CGST paid by customer to, you can say, dealer, and SGST paid by customer to dealer. So it is rupees 2622. So therefore total amount paid by customer, the question is the amount which the consumer pay for the TV. Therefore total amount consumer pay, total amount the consumer will pay will be equal to this initial amount, which is 43,700. So 43,700 plus 2,622 plus 2,622. So 2 plus 2, 4. I will write 4. 2 plus 2, 4. I will write 4. 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 7, 19. So 1 is carry. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, and then we have 4. So total amount the consumer will pay is 48,944. This is one of the problem. So this is solution for that. The third question is the amount of tax paid by retailer to the central government. So retailer, how much he will pay? So input tax, first we will calculate what is input GST, input CGST and SGST, okay, paid by retailer. So here I will say that input CGST paid by dealer or retailer? Retailer. So for retailer, the cost price is rupees 40,000. We multiply by 40,000. 4 sigma 24. So this is 2,400. So this is the CGST paid by retailer, and similarly input SGST paid by retailer. This is again 2,400. Output what is output CGST received by retailer from consumer, retailer will charge, and this is rupees 2,622. This is 2,622. Okay, this much output CGST has received. Similarly, output SGST we calculate, and output SGST is also 2,622. Okay. Now the problem is the amount of tax paid by retailer to the central government. So therefore amount of tax, therefore amount of tax paid by retailer, therefore the amount of tax paid by retailer to central government amount of tax paid by retailer to central government. A retailer, how much he will pay to central government? It is output CGST minus input CGST. Retailer will pay this difference only. So output CGST which he has collected is 2,000. 622, and what he already paid is 2400. So this difference he will pay. So 2622 minus 2400, it will give 222. So rupees 222 is the amount of tax paid by the retailer to the central government. And the next question, amount of tax received by state government. So amount of tax received by state government. So state government will receive all SGST what the customer is paying. So it is 2622. So end user, what the total tax he is paying is the final amount which central government or state government receives. So here in this case it is rupees 2622. So here it is rupees 2622. This is the amount of tax received by the state government. Yes. Okay, so this is your question 11. Now, the 12th problem is a shopkeeper buys an article from a manufacturer for rupees 12,000 and mark up its price by 25%. Marks up means he increases the price. The shopkeeper gives a discount of 10% on the marked price and he gives a further off season discount of 5% on the balance to the customer of TV. If the sales are intrastate and the rate of GST is 12%, find the price inclusive of tax which the consumer pay for the TV, the amount of tax paid by shopkeeper to the state government and the amount of tax received by the central government. Okay, so every time same kind of questions you are getting. Here the cost price for the shopkeeper, we will say that cost price is rupees 12,000. Okay, then marked price, so he increases the price by 25%, so it is 1 plus 25 divided by 100 times rupees 12,000. This is the marked price. Okay, let us calculate it. So 25 fours are, now 4 plus 1, it is 5, 5 divided by 4, 5 divided by 4 times 12,000. So the marked price, therefore the marked price we will get as 5 into 4, 3 is 12, so it is 3,000, and 5, 3 is 15, so it is 15,000. So marked price is 15,000. Now the shopkeeper give a discount of 10%. So price after, I will say that price after 10% discount. Price after 10% discount, it will be 1 minus 10 upon 100 multiplied by this 15,000. So price after 10% discount, it will come out to be this 0 we cancel, 10 minus 1, it is 9, 9 divided by 10 multiplied by 15,000. So 15 nines are 135, so it is 135 00, that is 13,500. This is a price after 10% discount. Okay, now next what is said, that the shopkeeper give a discount of 10% on the marked price and he gave a further off season discount of 5% on the balance to the customer of TV. So there is a further discount of 5%. Further discount of 5%. Okay, so therefore price after 5% discount. So now this 5% discount, we are getting on this 13,500, because on this is the balance amount which we have to pay, and on this the shopkeeper has given 5% additional discount. So the price after 5% discount, we will calculate it is 1 minus, now 5 and the 5, 5 to the 10, so it is 20 minus 1 into 13,500. So this will be something, 20 minus 1, it is 19 upon 20 into 13,500. This 0 we cancel, and this we will get as 19 into 2, 6 are 12, 1, it is 15, 2, 7 are 14, 1 and 2 5 are, and then 19 5 are 100, 19 5 are 95, so I will write 5 here. Okay, or better, this 675 you multiply by 19, see here, 9 5 are 45, 4 9 7 are 63, 63 plus 4 is 67, 6 9 6 are 54, 54 plus 6 is 60, then 1 5 are, it is 5, 1 7 are, it is 7, 1 6 are, it is 6. So this total is 5, it is 12, it is 8, and it is 12. So it is 12,825. It is 12,825. Okay. This is the amount that or the price which is there after 5% discount. So after 5% discount, the price is 12,825. Now, this is what a customer, for customer, this is what the selling price is. Now, GST and everything we will calculate on this price. So, this will be the output GST, okay, calculated. I have to calculate input GST as well as output GST. So, first I will start with input GST. So, input GST, CGST, I will say that, input CGST. Paid by shopkeeper, input CGST paid by shopkeeper, it is, now total GST percentage is 12%, so it is, and total cost is rupees 12,000, so it is 6 divided by 100 into 12,000. So here 120 into 6, we will get 720. So this is input CGST paid by the shopkeeper. It is rupees 720. Okay. Next, input CGST. Then input SGST. Similarly, input SGST. The amount is going to remain same, it is 720. Now output CGST collected by shopkeeper, it is 6 divided by 100 multiplied by, now to customer the selling price is 12,825, so it is 12,825. So the calculation become little tough. First I will multiply, 6 5 is 30, 3 carry, 6 2 is 12, 12 plus 3, it is 15, 1 carry, 6 8 is 48 plus 1 49, 4 carry, 6 to the 12, 12 plus 4, 16, 1 carry, 6 1 the 6 plus 1, 7. So it is 76,950 divided by 100. So divide by 100, so this will give 6769.5. Output CGST collected by the shopkeeper is rupees 769. And similarly, output SGST collected by shopkeeper, it is also 769.5. Okay, So 720 is the input CGST and 769.5 is the output CGST and SGST, both are the same. Okay, now the problem, the price inclusive of tax which the consumer pay for the TV. So the price, the first problem we handle, the price which consumer pay including tax, including GST, we can say that this is going to be equal to the cost price is 12,825. The cost price is 12,825 plus the GSTs. What GST, output GST is 769.5. It is 769.5 plus 769.5. This 55, it will add up to 0. Then 9 plus 9, it is 18 plus 1, 19. 19 plus 5, it is 24. 2, okay. Then 2, 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 2, 14. 14 plus 2, 14 plus 2 is 16, 1 carry. Okay. Something I missed. Let us check again. After decimal. So here I should have decimal, right? 5 plus 5, 0. Decimal. It is 0. Then 1 carry. 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 1, 19. 19 plus 2. Something I am missing. 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 5. 18 plus 6, I can say that. 18 plus 6. So 18 plus 6, it is 24. So 4, I have written 2 is carry. Then 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 2, 14. 14 plus 2, 16. I have written 6. Then 1 carry, 7 plus 7, 14. Plus 1, 15. And 15 plus 8. So 15 plus 5, it is 20. 23, I will write 3 here. After 2 is carry, then 2 plus 2, it is 4. And this is 1. So 14,364 is the price which the consumer pay. 14,364. Okay, first part done. Now second part, if you see the second part is the amount paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. So the amount of tax. So here amount of tax state government, it is equal to output SGST minus input SGST. So output SGST is 769.5 and input SGST is 720. Just check again, it is 720. So the amount which the shopkeeper will pay to the central government, it is 769 minus 720. So this will be 49.5. It is 49.5. Okay, this is the amount which the shopkeeper will pay as a tax to the state government, right? And third part of the question, here we have third part of the question, is the amount of tax received by the central government. So amount of tax, so here amount of tax received by central government, so what finally customer has paid as a tax, that is rupees 769.5. so rupees, I will say that rupees 769.5, this is what the central government will receive as a tax. Yes. Okay, so this is our problem number 12. Now let us see problem 13. The printed price of the article is 40,000. A wholesaler in Uttar Pradesh buys the article from the manufacturer in Gujarat at a discount of 10%. on the printed price. Now the wholesaler sell the article to the retailer in Himachal at 5% above the printed price. If the rate of GST on the article is 18%, we have to find the amount inclusive of tax under GST paid by wholesaler for the article, the amount inclusive of tax paid by the retailer for the article, the amount of tax paid by the wholesaler to the central government, and the amount of tax received by the central government. Okay, so the printed price of an article. So we will start with that printed price. So printed price. Printed price is rupees 40,000. Now, a wholesaler in Uttar Pradesh buys the article from the manufacturer in Gujarat at a discount of 10%. So, selling price, we will say that selling price, okay, after a discount of 10%, selling price after a discount of 10% to wholesaler. So, wholesaler is purchasing. Wholesaler, okay. So the selling price after 10% discount, so there is a discount of 10%, so it is 1 minus 10 divided by 100 multiplied by this 40,000. So this is like 9 divided by 10 into 40,000. So this cancels and I will get the selling price as 36,000 rupees. Okay, so 40,000 was the printed price and the wholesaler bought it at rupees 36,000. Now the wholesaler sell the article to the retailer in Himachal Pradesh at 5% above the printed price. Okay, so selling price, we will say that selling price of article by wholesaler to retailer at 5% above the printed price. So above the printed price, what is said, the wholesaler sell the article to the retailer in Himachal Pradesh at 5% above the printed price. So 5% above the printed price. Okay, so this will be 1 plus 5 upon 100 multiplied by 40,000 because this is what the printed price is. So it is 1 plus, now it is 1 divided by 20 multiplied by 40,000. So it is 21 divided by 20. So this is 21 divided by 20 multiplied by 40,000. So this is 21 multiplied by 2 2's are 4. So it is 2000. So 21 to the, it is 42,000. So 42,000 is what the printed price, 5% above the printed price. This is what the wholesaler will sell to retailer at this price. The wholesaler will sell to the retailer. Now GST rate is 18%. The amount of the amount inclusive of tax paid by the wholesaler to the for the article. So therefore, first we will find the tax paid by wholesaler. So it is at 18%, and for wholesaler the cost is 36,000. So it is 18% for this 36,000. Now here I am not taking 9% because here I have to, means the whole tax is will go to central government only, as it is interstate transaction. The transaction is from one state to other state. So this will give you 18 multiplied by 360. So 18 multiplied by 360 0. 18 6 da. So 18 into 36. Here let us multiply this 36 by 18. 8 6 da. 48 and 8 3 da. 24. 24 plus 4 is 28. Then 1 6 da 6 and 1 3 da 3. So this is 8. This is 4. This is 6. 648. So 6480. 6480 is what the wholesaler will pay as a tax. So therefore we can say that the amount paid by wholesaler for the article, therefore here the amount paid by wholesaler for article. So the wholesaler will pay how much? He will pay what is the cost price, that is 36,000. It is 36,000 plus 6,480. Okay, so this will give here 0, 8, here 8, then 4 plus 0, here 4 we have, then 6 plus 6, 12, and 3 plus 1, 4. So, the amount paid by wholesaler for the article is 42,480. This is the amount paid by wholesaler for the article. Okay. The amount inclusive of tax paid by the retailer for the article. Now, in the same way, GST, I will say that tax or GST paid by retailer so again it is at 18%, so 18 upon 100 multiplied by 42,000, because the selling price to the customer or retailer, it is 42,000. So with on this amount, if we calculate 18 to the 36, so here I will write 0, here I will write 6, 3 is carrying, and 18 for the 72, 72 plus 3 is 75, 7560. Here it is 6480. Always I compare what the wholesaler pays tax and what the retailer pays tax. Always the tax of retailer will be more because the price for retailer is more. Okay, so that gives you a hint that whether you are going in right direction or not. So 7560, this is the GST paid by retailer. So therefore total amount, you can say that total amount inclusive of GST, you can say that total amount paid by retailer, total amount paid by retailer is equals to retailer, he paid 42,000 as the cost price plus, so 42,000 was his cost price plus 7560 was the tax. So here it is 0, then 6, then 5, then 7 plus 2, 9, and then 4. So 49,560 is the amount which the retailer has paid. Now the amount of tax paid by wholesaler to central government. So amount of tax here to central government so this will output GST minus input GST. Output means what he collected from retailer. So how much he collected from the retailer? 7560 he collected from the retailer. 7650, this is what he collected from the retailer, minus now what he paid. So he initially paid 6418. 6000 he paid 6480. Okay, so the difference is, I will write 0 here, then 15 minus 8, I will write 7, then here 5 minus 4, 1, and then 6 minus 7, it is again 1. So 1170, what is the amount the wholesaler pay to the central government? The difference he will pay to the central government. 7560 the tax which the retailer have to pay, and 6480 what is the tax wholesaler have to pay. So the difference the wholesaler will pay to the central government. Okay, the amount of tax which the wholesaler paid to the central government and the amount of tax received by the central government. Last question, amount of tax, final question, amount of tax received by central government. So what the final tax paid by the retailer will be received by central government, that is 7560. So 7560, this is the final tax, it is paid by retailer. So 7560, if there was some customer, then what tax customer has paid, that we calculate. But here the end person is retailer. Okay, at last retailer has purchased the things and he has paid a tax of rupees 7560. So we will say that the tax which is received by the government is 7560, and all these tax will be received by central government, as here the transactions involved between two different states. Okay, so yes, all the problems are lengthy. Okay, but for each single problem, like here it is the sum of four problems, you can say that, and for each problem there must be some marks, so the marks will justify the length of the problem. Okay, so thank you for this class. In the next class we will see a few more questions.